जय हो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू एसके सीबीएसई डीजी विद्या क्लास सेशन। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, यस्टरडे वी हैव सीन दैट रिविजिटिंग रैशनल नंबर्स एंड देयर डेसिमल एक्सपांशन, सो इन दैट वी हैव आल्सो डिस्कस्ड थ्योरम वन। सो व्हाट फर्स्ट थ्योरम स्टेट्स, सो वंस अगेन आई एम गोइंग टू रिकॉल इट। सो व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट थ्योरम स्टेटमेंट, सो दैट इज Let x is one of the rational number, x be a rational number and whose decimal expansion terminates. X is given as one of the rational number, already it is given, and its decimal expansion is terminating, and whose decimal expansion terminates. Then x can be written as, x can be expressed as p by q, where p and q are co-primes, and the prime factorization of q is of the form 2 to the power n into 5 to the power m, where n and m are non-negative integers. So that was the statement of theorem 1. Now let us discuss the theorem 2. So what is that theorem states? So it is totally converse of theorem 1. What is that first theorem? In the statement they have given, what they have given, that x is one of the rational number whose decimal expansion is terminates. Clear? Then after giving this statement, then what we need to prove, that what we have to prove, that is x can be expressed, then x can be expressed as p by q form, where p and q are co-primes, and the prime factorization of q is of the form 2 to the power n into 5 to the power m. That we need to prove. Yeah, but in this theorem, this is the converse of theorem 1. So what is that theorem states? Second theorem states, what is the statement of this theorem? Here we have to look at the board first. Let x is equals to p by q, it means it is one of the rational number. Let x is equals to p by q be a rational number. We have taken that x is one of the rational number such that the prime factorization of q, what is that? The prime factorization of q is of the form 2 to the power n into 5 to the power m, where m and n are non-negative integers. Then what we have to prove? Then the decimal expansion which is terminates. Yeah, whatever rational number we have taken, no, its decimal expansion is terminating. Clear? So this is the statement of theorem 2, that is converse of theorem 1. In theorem 1, what they have given? X is a rational number, it can be expressed in the form of p by q, whose decimal expansion is terminates. Then what we have to prove? Then the prime factorization of q is of the form 2 to the power n into 5 to the power m. But in this theorem, in second theorem, what they have given? They have given that x is one of the rational number that can be expressed as p by q form, and the prime factorization of q is given. Yeah, what is that prime factorization of q? Is of the form 2 to the power n into 5 to the power m, where m and n are non-negative integers, then x has a decimal expansion which terminates. Yeah, this is the theorem. So what it says, for example, I will give one example. So then we will conclude. So x, what they have given? It is one of the rational number. If it is a rational number, then it can be written in the form of P by Q form. It can be written in the form of P by Q form. Then the prime factorization of Q must be in what form? 2 to the power n into 5 to the power m. That is P divided by Q can be written as 2 to the power n into 5 to the power m. Then we can say x has terminating decimal expansion. Here x has terminating decimal expansion. If Q can be written in this form, the prime factorization of Q is of the form 2 to the power n into 5 to the power m, then we can say that x has decimal expansion which terminates. Yeah, so then we can say that x has a decimal expansion which terminates. So this is the theorem 2. Clear? So next we have to see that theorem 3. The theorem 3. So what the theorem 3 states? Clear? So just now we have seen theorem 2. What was the theorem 2? Let x equals to p by q be a rational number. Rational number, the prime factorization of Q is of the form 2 to the power n into 5 to the power m. Then we can say that the rational number has, that is, x has a decimal expansion which terminates. When it is possible, the prime factorization of Q is of the form 2 to the power n into 5 to the power m, then we can say that the decimal expansion of x, that is the given rational number, is terminating. Yeah, so that was the second theorem. Now the theorem 3 states, what is that? The statement of theorem 3. So here we have seen, in first theorem, the prime factorization of Q is of the form 2 to the power n into 5 to the power m. Even in second theorem also, the prime factorization of Q is of the form 2 to the power n into 5 to the power m. Suppose the prime factorization of Q is not of the form 2 to the power n into 5 to the power m, then what happens? What will be the decimal expansion of the given rational number? That statement gives the theorem 3. Yeah. So what is the statement of theorem 3? Here, let x is equals to p by q be a rational number. X is what? One of the rational number, and that can be expressed in the form of p by q. X is equals to p by q be a rational number such that the prime factorization of q is not of the form. In second theorem it was of the form q. The prime factorization of the q is of the form 2 to the power n into 5 to the power n. But here in the third statement, in the third theorem, let x be a rational number, x is equals to p by q be a rational number such that the prime factorization of q is not of the form 2 to the power n into 5 to the power m, where m and n are non-negative integers. then the decimal expansion we have to check of x rational number. Then x has a decimal expansion which is non-repeating, no, it is for irrational numbers. So x has the decimal expansion which is non-terminating repeating, or it is also called as recurring. Clear? So this is the theorem 3. What is the statement of theorem 3? Let x be, x is equals to p by q, be a rational number such that the prime factorization of q is not of the form 2 to the power n into 5 to the power m, where m and n are non-negative integers, and then x has decimal expansion which is non-terminating repeating. Clear? So then we can say this is non-terminating repeating decimal expansion. Suppose here what they have given, x be a rational number, then it can be written in the form of p by q. X is equals to p by q. Then q is not of the form, q is not equal to of the form, that is 2 to the power n into 5 to the power m. Then we can say the decimal expansion of x is non-terminating and repeating, recurring. Clear? I hope you understood this one, that is theorem 3. In the next class, we discuss some examples based on theorem 1, theorem 2, theorem 3. So till then, take care. Jai Hind.